Milan.
Hi, Andrea.
Hi. District energy is changing a lot.
Yes.
And it will be really one of the key solutions to tackle the energy transition and the heat transition. But at the same time, there is more and more complexity as well. And for the consumer, obviously, it's important to get heat in a reliable way delivered.
Yeah.
On the other hand, for the provider of the heat, the utilities, it's also important to be resilient and to make sure that there is a good supply of service. So in that context, what do you think is important and how would you describe that?
Well, I think here what we are actually talking about, or at least the terminology that we also are using in latest period, is actually the importance of digitalization, how to handle this complexity, and in that sense also the end-to-end optimization of the district energy network, so that we basically optimize the whole chain. Basically, as we like to say in district energy world, the optimization of the district energy system, that is the primary side, right, the production sources and the network, always starts by optimizing the secondary side. That's the building, you know. And digital technology allows us here basically to couple these two worlds, right, into one system, and allows us to drive it in a most technically and also, of course, cost-efficient way. But in that sense, also securing basically the reliability and also the end user comfort.
So that's what you would call end-to-end optimization.
Exactly, yes, that we optimize the secondary side, but not just ensuring that the secondary side or the building is acting as an isolated island optimally, but it is utilizing mostly digital technology, also connected to the primary side, so that we are utilizing all this data and the information from the secondary side, so that we efficiently also run the primary side, meaning, for instance, you mentioned complexity. Today, in the district energy systems are getting more and more complex. We are introducing renewables, we are introducing waste heat sources that are in many cases lying basically abandoned around the cities. It means that district energy has multiple production sources. They all have their technical characteristics, limitations. They also have their own price, right? And now we need to be able to figure out where and how do we produce this energy, and how and when do we deliver to the customer, to ensure the customer needs, but also to ensure that we do this basically in the most cost efficient and technologically efficient way. So this is actually where digital technology or digitalization is basically enabling us to do so much more efficiently than we would be able to do in the past manually, right?
And can you say a little bit more about the digital solutions that we propose in order to achieve this, what you were just describing?
Yeah, of course. If we go back, for instance, to the building level, here we are already, I think a lot of customers already know our ECL controllers, the weather compensators. They are already very renowned for their quality and control efficiency. But we are also here introducing a lot of innovation. For instance, ISET INET technology is basically intelligent actuators that we innovated are used with our differential pressure actuators. It basically means that we are combining two worlds, right? Something that was traditionally very mechanical, self-acting product. Now we are putting digital, combining it with digital technology, so that we can actually proactively or dynamically adapt the parameters of how we actually deliver the heat into the building. And by this, we are basically tapping into the previously unreachable potential of improving the control efficiency. And then, of course, adding connectivity on these products, it allows us to collect all the necessary data so that we are able to better understand how the buildings are behaving. We are actually much more today, much better able to understand how the demand is correlated to different things like weather, like type of the building, right? Commercial, multifamily houses, right? And based on this, we are able actually also to predict the demand. And utilizing all this knowledge, this allows us to much more efficiently drive this complexity in the production sources, right? Because we are able to predict, you know, and also drive or optimize the primary side of the network. Also, again, tapping into the previously unreachable potential, for instance, the INET technology. Here again, we talk about digitalized differential pressure actuators that allow us to balance the primary side of the network. And basically, by balancing it, we are unlocking potential, hidden potential in the flow capacity so that we can connect additional buildings onto the existing network without, for instance, investing into the bigger pumps or adding new production sources. So there's quite a lot of benefits, probably much more than I've described today, but digital technology is here and basically collecting this data, utilizing it, we are learning day by day, and innovation here is fascinating.
Yeah, and I think also what is really special is that we have both the hardware and the software.
Exactly.
And therefore a quite unique expertise.
Exactly. And not just hardware and software, but as a company, we are really specialized into the primary side of the district energy system, but also into the secondary side in the building, you know. So we are really able to utilize these competencies, this knowledge to interconnect this two elements into one system that works end-to-end in the most technically and the cost efficient way.
Perfect. And I think with district energy being so important and having this need to be further deployed in order to master the heat transition, I think everything you just described is just a perfect solution.
Exactly. And what is needed on the market.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.